Okay, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on.
Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you want to see how I got this fancy red maple leaf eye look, please keep on watching. Hi guys, welcome back. And just to get started, I have already prepped my face with my Bobbi Brown face base. I'm actually going to be trying out the new Anastasia Beverly Hills foundation sticks. I have heard a bit of complaints about them because they might be a little too stiff to work with, but they are meant for oily combination skin, which is what I have, so I'm going to do everything I can to work with this. I swatched myself in the store and I am Warm Natural, and then I picked up Fawn as the contour shade. I just wanted to note that the Sephora associate told me not to use a beauty blender, or at least not a wet one, so I am going to be trying my Ulta foundation brush. You could also probably try like a MAC 190, like a good synthetic flat brush for this, or a dry beauty blender, but I'm just going to try a regular brush for this and see what happens. I want to say, I already really like this foundation. I think it's easy to work with if you use a brush. I can see how this can be difficult if you use something like a wet beauty blender. Applying it directly to the skin is working for me, and then blending it out right away. I have a feeling because it's for oily skin, it tends to set really fast. So people who like do their whole face and then they try to blend it out, maybe part of their face looks better than the other because it's already set. So I'm just gonna keep going, but I'm gonna go in sections of the face so that nothing sets until I say so. Okay, so more first impressions. This is a very skin-like foundation, but I would not call this super full coverage, at least not on the first go. I'd probably say it's like medium coverage, maybe even light if you put a little bit, but I don't know if it's buildable yet. I don't want super full coverage today, so I'm not gonna be able to tell you whether or not this is totally full coverage. The right finish between probably dewy and matte. So it's not too shiny or too dewy, and it's not so matte that my face looks really flat. So far, so good. Keep going. And now I'm gonna go in with the new Kat Von D Lock It Concealer, and I'm in M17, warm. This is my first time ever using Kat Von D concealer or foundation products, so I will probably be using a beauty blender for this since it's full coverage. I really like the applicator on this. I don't know if you can see this. It's like a tilted doe foot, and it's got a little bit of a broader triangle shape, but it's really nice. And this is a very creamy concealer. Damp beauty blender is the way to go. I like this foundation so much that I'm not even gonna put concealer anywhere else on my face, just my under eyes. I already love it. I am, however, going to set my under eyes. I'm using a sample I picked up of the RCMA No Color Powder. I got it on CameraReadyCosmetics.com because I love trying things before I buy things. My very, very astute boyfriend just pointed out they had a little pink on my cheeks. I thought I put foundation there, but it could just be because my cheeks are very pink and this isn't super full coverage, so we shall see. And now I am gonna set my under eyes. And I'm just using my damp beauty blender. And I'm gonna brush this away with my Real Techniques setting brush. So I'm gonna go in with Fawn and just contour my cheekbones a little bit. And I'm using the same brush that I used for the foundation. Feel like it's very subtle, just like the foundation. So if you want subtle contour and you're not looking for like that intense drag contour, this is for you. If you want really intense contour, get a darker color than Fawn, because Fawn is like a really nice neutral like gray brown. So it's a great contour color if you're looking for natural contour. This just makes me look a little thinner and I'm okay with that. I'm dropping everything. Okay, so let's do eyeballs. I was feeling like reds. Oh, I was watching an episode of The Sopranos and it just so happened to be an episode that was in the fall and Paulie Galtieri is looking out the window at his mother's nursing home room and it's like really bright red maple leaves and that just totally made me want to do like bright red eyes. But it's really easy to do bright red eyes that end up looking like you have pink eye or that you got punched in the eye. We're gonna try not to do that. The more intense we go with the red, the more kind of editorial it's gonna look. Or if you go a more red-brown route, it's gonna look like really natural and pretty. All right, so I forgot to do brows. I'm gonna do that before I go into eyes. I'm gonna start off with the Anastasia Brow Primer. A little bit goes a long way, kids. This is amazing, because my brows are unruly. And then I'm just gonna brush it through with my Anastasia number 7 brush. Okay, and next I'm gonna take my Anastasia Brow Powder Duo, and this one is Taupe. I just wanted to go for a little bit of a more neutral color since our eyes are going to be super intense, I've decided. And I'm going with the darker color. Brush that through one more time. And now the other side. And then I kind of usually death stare into my mirror until they look even enough for me. That'll do. I lied. That'll do. That'll do? Yeah. I'm not setting my brows. They do their own thing. I try not to control them other than just filling them in. They can be very rebellious. And now on to eyes. I picked up the Melt Rust Stack and I love it. I got it a couple months ago. It's one of my favorites, and it's perfect for fall. What's more fall-like than rust? Rust. I'm just going to go all over my eye with the first color, which is called Classic. It's kind of just like a cream colored matte. Oh, and my Smith 235 brush. I am pretty satisfied with that. Next, I'm gonna go in with Makeup Geek's Coco Bear and my MAC 217. And I'm just dragging this like way past the natural point where I would normally put a color like this. You can be as subtle as you want with this color combination, but I feel a little crazy for a Sunday night. I'm a huge fan of taking your time to build up color to get exactly what you want versus putting way too much on and then being really annoyed that you have to go wash your face. And I'm going back in with my Smith 235. I didn't clean it off or anything. It probably still has a little bit of classic on it. And I'm just gonna blend all that. I'm still working with Makeup Geek's Coco Bear and my MAC 217, and I'm bringing a little bit of the color closer to the front of my brow. And then I blend it out with the same Smith 235. I'm just gonna do a swatch comparison right now because I am kind of curious. Okay. So this is Melt Cosmetics Rust from the Rust Stack, and this is Makeup Geek's Coco Bear. So Rust is a little bit darker. I'm gonna darken up my crease a little bit with this first. The reason I did a swatch comparison, always do a swatch comparison, is because if it was too similar of a color, I probably would have just been doing the same thing to my eye, and that's kind of redundant. Nami. So now I'm gonna take my E36 Sigma blending brush and melt Rust. And darken up my crease. Ooh yeah, nice subtle, not so subtle. These colors go really, really well together. They're like best friends. And then I'm going back in with my 217. That probably has some Coco Bear on it. I'm just blending that out a little bit. Just a little. A light hand goes a long way. And now I'm gonna take a Melt Cosmetics Rot, also from the Rust Stack. This is the darkest color in the stack. And my same E36, and really concentrate that right in the outer V of my eye. Again, with my 217, just blending out that edge. And then my Real Techniques setting brush just to clean up any fallout that I have. There isn't a lot of fallout, but with any matte shades, you're always gonna get a little bit of fallout. I personally love all of the Melt eyeshadow stacks. Next, I'm going to go in with the Too Faced Shadow Insurance Glitter Glue and Sugar Pill's Loose Pigment in Asylum. It's a really nice red. I was gonna use a brush, but I think I might just use my fingers. Why not? And I'm only doing it to the center of my lid. I'm just patting it. I'm not moving anything back and forth because I don't want to mess with the shadow underneath. And I really pat it in just until it feels tacky enough. And then I'm going to go in with my Asylum. Look at this color, it's so beautiful. And my MAC 247 brush. I'm focusing everything on the center and then just kind of patting it out. I'll blend it a little bit later. Okay, and then with my Sigma Exact Blend E32 brush and Kat Von D's Metal Crush eyeshadow in Raw Power, I'm just gonna blend out the edges a little bit. And then I'm gonna take Melt Rust again and just clean up the edges with my E36. I'm gonna take Sugar Pill's Diamond Eyes and I'm going to go into the inner corner with that. Okay, and then I'm going to take my ColourPop gel liner in Swerve and my Smith 202 brush and just do a really tiny wing. I guess it's not going to be a really tiny wing now. See, now I normally don't set my whole face. But I'm noticing, because I'm kind of like leaning my hand a tiny bit on my face, that the foundation isn't really setting. If you're okay with that and that's not gonna bother you, then that's totally fine. I think I might set that. I normally don't set my foundation like whole face, but like just because I touched it, it came off and now you can see like the pink that naturally happens in my cheeks. Learning curve. Cool. Now I'm gonna do the outer wing with my Anastasia number 14 brush. Now I'm gonna do the other eye off camera. Now I'm going to do my under eyes. I'm gonna go back in with the Melt Rust deck because I just love it so much. And I'm gonna take the color Rust and Rot and I'm just kinda gonna do a little reddish brown thing on the bottom and see how that goes. Also, I'm gonna start off with my MAC 217. I lied, I'm gonna start off with my MAC 239. I'm gonna blend this out with my MAC 217 till I get like a nice smoky rust. I'm gonna darken the outer corner a tiny bit with Rot and my E36. So I am going to curl my lashes with the Tarte Lash Curler. And then I'm gonna put on my MAC Hot and Naughty Mascara, waterproof. I love this mascara. And then I'm actually going to try the House of Lashes minis. They came out with a couple minis, I think one of which is Iconic and the other one is Siren. There's another one. I don't remember the third. But I have the Siren minis, and because I have smaller eyes, I'm gonna try those out. First with the curling. And I'm gonna use the narrow wand. It's like two wands in one. It's probably just one wand that comes apart. Yes. Oh, it just takes off more mascara. Interesting. I learned something new about the mascara I've been using forever. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with my Eskito Lash Companion Glue and my Siren Minis by House of Lashes. Can't open it. Now I am going to warm up the face a little bit with my little Hoola Bronzer Mini that I picked up. I've heard a lot of good things about the Benefit Hoola, but I've actually never used it. I'm pretty dead set on my Tarte Park Avenue Princess, so I might as well give this a go. And in order to avoid this looking too Christmassy, I'm gonna warm up my face like crazy. I'm gonna try out the little brush that came with this, because why not? Okay, I'm gonna take a moment right now to say that I definitely feel like the foundation isn't really separating, but it's definitely not setting. But it does still feel very comfortable on my skin. It's not like it feels greasy at all. I do not like setting my entire face with powder, but I feel like when I use these foundation sticks, I'm going to have to. Let me go grab my Laura Mercier setting powder and take care of that. Oh, and my Morphe M509. So because I set my whole face with a powder, I kind of look a little too matte for my liking, so I am going to have to go in with a highlight, which I really don't mind. So I am going to go in with my powder highlighter, the Anastasia Beverly Hills Sun Dipped Glow Kit, and my Anastasia Beverly Hills 823 brush. Do my lips. I wanted to do something sort of neutral, so I have Kat Von D's Everlasting Liquid Lipstick in Bow and Arrow. No lip liner because I don't feel like it. It ain't real until the hair comes down. And that is the final look, guys. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and learned a little something. I will list a description of everything I used in order in my little description box, as well as link all my social media accounts in case you want to follow me there too. If you want to see more tutorials like this, please also let me know in the comments down below. Feel free to hit that like and subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching again, guys. Have a fantastic day.